as I was outside working in my yard. I love seeing all the bulbs I planted in the fall begin to poke through the ground. It reminds me of the scripture in Isaiah 43:19 that declares, "Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall you not know it? I will even make a road in the wilderness and rivers in the desert." Behold actually means to stand in awe and be amazed. And you and I, we can be amazed knowing we have God, Almighty God, as Isaiah 32, 17 and 18 declares, "He is a God who made the heavens and the earth by his great power, by his outstretched arm. Nothing is too difficult for him." Almighty God declares, "Behold, I am doing a new thing in you and me, in our life, in our destiny, in the plans that he has for us to give us hope and a future." God is calling us up out of the ordinary to rise above the limits. Kind of reminds me of the dirt, the ground. It's a limit. But God wants us to rise up above it. He's asking us to see and respond to his hand of preparation, the purpose that he has for each of our lives, to behold what he has done, what he's doing, and will continue to do in you and me in our lives, according to the word of God, and with a vision to see that his kingdom will come on earth as it is in heaven, a God that has no limits. With him, all things are possible. I want to encourage you, my friend, as we look to spring, as we spring forward into this season, that we can go forth with that declarative statement for ourselves. Behold, God is doing a new thing in me. God, who made a way for the Israelites who were in captivity, and after 70 years, he declared in his word, there was a prophetic promise that they will be liberated and redeemed. And God was calling his people out from the old and into a new season. He was calling things that were not as though they were. And they had already happened as far as he was concerned, because in his mind, when he declares a promise, he does not lie like man. He watches over his word to perform it. His word that is alive and active. His word that is filled with possibilities because it is enriched with his almighty power. Are you expecting God to do a new thing in your life? He has promised that he will make a way for you, that he will carve a road to lead you and position you to those rivers of provision to refresh you as well. Just as Isaiah says, that he will make a road in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. You know, my mother lives in Albuquerque, and not far from there is El Paso, where I met and married my husband. And the Rio Grande, where we lived during that time, was alive with trees and all kinds of greenery in the midst of a desert that you could see surrounding that river. Because the rivers in the desert, it brings life. God is bringing life in you and me, not only for our life, but as an overflow that we can be a blessing and a benefit to others. If anyone thirsts, the word declares, let him come unto me and drink. Jesus himself has promised that rivers of living water will brim and spill out of the depths of everyone who believes in his way, just as it says in John 7:38. So as much that is on the horizon, it's unlimited. You can see for miles. My mom in Albuquerque, I think that's one of the things I enjoy most, is the perspective. You can see so far because there's not the hills and the trees. It's just unlimited and vast. God is saying that in the horizon of our life, it is filled with unlimited possibilities. So we are not to be discouraged with the bumps in the road or the detours that are on the path, that we are to continue to trust Him, to put our faith in a God that says that He's got it. And we can trust Him and be confident that not only does He hear our prayers, but He is faithful to bring it to pass. And a God that is constantly speaking new things into the wilderness or the desert seasons. Ephesians 3:20 is a blessing I want to declare and a reminder of the promise that God has for you and me. And that is, never doubt, God's mighty power is at work in you to accomplish all this. He will achieve infinitely more than your greatest request, your most unbelievable dreams, and exceed your wildest imagination. He will outdo them all in His miraculous power. Come on now, His miraculous power constantly energizes you. My prayer is this, that God will help you to expect something new as you are faithful to continue to seek Him and seek first the kingdom of God, knowing that the overflow is yours to receive, that He will grant you wisdom as you ask for it, that He will respond with an overflow of insight, and that you and I, we will not be reactors. No, we will put our trust and our confidence in God and in His guidance, and we will choose to acknowledge Him in all our ways, to be thankful for those rivers of provision that He will provide at just the right time. May God's blessings be before you. May His blessings be within you. And may His blessings be behind you. For He is your rear guard. He is protecting you. He is leading you in the way that you should go. And His eye of counsel is upon you. God bless you, my friend. Thank you for joining us. I'm so glad you could be with us tonight, and I'll look forward to having you join us next week for our game time experience. A little unique and very special, but you certainly don't want to miss it. If you need more details, go to www.cindydennis.org. Thanks again, everyone. God bless you.